Now that we know what the subject matter of economics is, it's time to go a little deeper. Traditionally, the study of economics has been divided into microeconomics and macroeconomics. The names are very suggestive. Micro deals with the small and macro with the large. In particular, microeconomics is concerned with individuals, individual firms, individual consumers, and individual industry. We saw Pranjal choosing between clothes, movies, and food earlier. That is a microeconomic decision. If clothes became more expensive, then she may buy fewer clothes or watch fewer movies. What should she do? Well, how she should decide is partly what microeconomics is about. Similarly, we saw Avinash worrying about whether to hire a full-time salesperson or to hire a developer to get quicker solutions for the product. What if salespeople's salaries go up? Can Avinash match the salaries? We will have to depend upon microeconomics to answer that. Arun Jaitley has very different concerns. His problem is to spur the growth of the Indian economy. How does he do that? Maybe he should increase government expenditure. That might increase the fiscal deficit, though. Would that increase inflation? If so, it might hurt the economy. By and large, he is worried about big issues. Growth, fiscal deficit, inflation. His concerns belong to the world of macroeconomics. Though, of course, he also has to worry about microeconomics issues. So, macroeconomics is the study of the aggregates. How are the two related? Shouldn't macroeconomics be the sum of all the microeconomies? If we want to find out how increased expenditure affects the whole economy, can't we look at how every individual consumer, business and industries are affected by the government's policy decisions? We could in theory, but it's impossible in practice. Given the size and complexity of a country like India, it is impossible to find out how each part of the economy responds. So, we have to try other means, and that is the subject matter of macroeconomics. So, for this time being, the study on microeconomics and macroeconomics must remain separate, though we are getting closer with better technology.